But and she, if I may go back to you,
mm-hmm. because did it affect your career when you stepped in the open world and you wrote this letter? I mean, your ex-husband is a famous actor, Johnny Depp. Did that affect your career?
Oh, yeah, of course. It's still to this day, you know, is a constant threat to my safety, my family's safety.
Seriously?
Yes, of course. And, you know, just like anybody who goes...
But Emma, for a lot of people, that would be a reason not to speak up. What is the reason for you to stand out and say, I don't accept this?
Because I am incredibly lucky and privileged. So with that privilege and with that luck, with that fortune, I have the same responsibility to do with that.
Is it also a way to
right.
deal with your personal situation?
It isn't about me. It isn't about me. My job is to do with that privilege what women without that privilege cannot. Mm. Not just with regards to domestic violence, this is a human rights mm-hmm. issue. Women's rights are human rights. And it, with an amplified voice comes an amplified responsibility to do with that what is right and right. to speak for people who don't have a voice.
And actually were all kinds of accusations flying your way when you said all this, and then there was a divorce settlement, you got $7 million. People were saying this is all about the money, but then you did something that twisted that whole argument. What did you do with that money?
$7 million in total was donated to... I split it between the ACLU and Children's Hospital of Los Angeles.
ACLU is a human rights organization.
Sorry, ACLU is a prominent organization, nonprofit organization in the United States. Yeah. It's called the American right. Civil Liberties Union, and they work on behalf of marginalized communities on the ground and in legislative reform.
Right.
And
well, more power to you, because that's something that I've never heard of.
I wanted nothing.
Well, Emma, are you happy?
Yes.
Okay, I'm
absolutely.
Happy to hear that.
Yeah. I am.
Yeah.
I am. I'm very
happy. I think
that's
happy. So important, yeah.
There's nothing that would make me happier than being able to live my life safely and doing with my time that which I can maybe hope changes the life of one yeah. person.
Question though, because as you have said already, this can make situations worse, because like for many women, men are fighting back who have been accused of this, and your ex-husband recently said in a GQ interview in a magazine, this is not true, that this didn't happen. So the fight continues, goes on.
You know, I can't speak about that. And I have no interest in it. All I want to do is support women and change the narrative and change the conversation surrounding how we as a culture deal with women who do dare to come up against powerful men and the people that aim to benefit from that power and maintain the status quo. I am not speaking about myself. I'm not speaking about my relationship. Why would I? Mm. I am here to speak on behalf of
a new generation. A big problem is that they always confuse the fact that it's always powerful men who abuse women, but that's not the case. Mm. You know, women generally can be abused by any man, and I think that's the bigger right. discussion that we should have.
And that's what you stated here very clearly. Thank you so much for talking about this. It's very brave, and I wish you all the best in your life, and thank you for coming to the Netherlands and do this speech in The
thank
Hague.
You. Thank you.
Thanks a million. Zometeen Nederland moet stoppen met roken, tenminste als het aan de politiek ligt. Politiek verslaggever Marloes Lemson, die was vandaag in Den Haag, om staatssecretaris Blokhuis aan de tand te voelen over zijn plannen. En Laurens van den Akker is hoofdverantwoordelijk voor het design van automerk Renault en weet in wat voor auto wij over 20 jaar rijden. En hij rijdt de hits in rap tempo aan één. En ik ben trots dat hij hier is, David Guetta.